Okay, welcome back to the lab, and here we are. These are the two D1s. These are 577s, but they are the D1s, so they do have the storage tube function. This has the more rare graticule. This has the standard graticule. The squares are bigger, and it doesn't have the uncalibrated edges. This guy's in pretty rough shape. Not 100% sure what it was used for. This had a bunch of writing. I've cleaned the front of it a little bit because this had a bunch of writing for settings on the front of it. It had some medical terminology on the front of it, so I have no idea what this was used for in the medical field. If anybody knows, please let me know. This one I do know came out of a biotech lab. Given the way the tube is, I'm pretty sure it was used for one measurement and one measurement only, and that was it. Because it has some burn in it. But I'll show you guys that here in a second. This is what's going on with these two tubes, and this is what I actually don't know. So if a storage tube has been off for a very long period of time according to the manual is 2 weeks, you need to let the flood guns re-energize the screen. The other thing with the storage tubes is they are very, very easy to burn in. So even if the tube is well taken care of, the storage tubes are far more susceptible to burn in than the standard tubes. So I haven't seen a storage tube yet without some burn in, especially on a curve tracer, because the spot here, the spot in the center, and the spot up here, it's always a spot. It's always on, especially around the center. So what I'll do is I'll fire both of these tubes up and I'll show you what they're doing. I've read the manual several times. Thought about it for a while, tried to figure out what was going on. I think I know which one's working correctly, but I'm kind of asking you guys as well, what do you guys think is working correctly? So if I turn the intensity down all the way, focus is just set for a focus trace. You turn the brightness up all the way, put it in storage mode, and then you turn it on. And this is to bring the tubes back after you've had them in storage or something like that for over 2 weeks. You just turn them on and you leave it that way for 6 minutes. That's according to the service manual that I have. So what it does is it floods out the guns. So as you can see, this one came in real fast. This one's coming in a lot slower. Here's the one mark of burn-in on this one. I don't know if you guys can see it through the camera, but there's this tiny bit of burn-in right here. Also, this has some burn-in down here at the center and a little bit in the middle. So it's got tiny dot there, and a tiny dot down there. That's just because it's a storage tube. The tube's actually really healthy on that one. You can see this one's still filling out slowly. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to leave it like that. And we will go from there, and I'll show you guys what I think is happening and which one I think is actually functioning correctly. So I'll leave that sit, and after 6-10 minutes, I'll be back, and I'll show you what's going on. Okay, I've waited the requisite time frame, and as you can see, this tube is completely washed out. But we can see on this one the individual flood guns. You can see the individual flood guns, and this took a while to... Actually, it's most dramatic over here. This took a while to get this way. Around 5-6 minutes. So, my opinion is, this is the CRT that's adjusted correctly. The D1 store, this one... does not. The storage in the CRT is running too hot. So what I'll do is I'll erase it. And you can see an even different effect. Move the camera back. Set this to erase. Hit erase. Hit erase. So if I hit erase, you can see this one comes back and the brightness increases. If I hit erase over here, nothing happens. I think this tube is much more behaved. This one's out of adjustment, so I think this one needs work. let me know what you guys think, and we'll see what we can do to get this started. The only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just work on cleaning up some switches, getting everything all set up and oiled up. This has seen better days. Giant crack here. This knob's missing. The readout on this skirted knob is actually in really bad shape. This one's really hard to read, so this 177 is going to need some work. This D1's going to need some work. Definitely some cleanup work. The other D1's going to need some calibration. So let me know what you guys think, and we'll go from there.